Look out, kissy cat. Coming through. Lady on a mission. Oh, yeah. Guess it'd be cool to see what y'all are talking about. I hope you all had an awesome day. What's today? Wednesday? Nope.
Wednesday.
Hey y'all.
Look at Bowie.
You playing with the cats?
Well, don't scare the kitty cat. He's trying to play with them. And now the cat's getting sideways. Uh-oh. Now the girl cat's going to sneak up on him.
She's
sneaking up on
me. Not going to get the jump on my little bean.
No, Bean's nose to stay far, far away.
Nene, what are you cooking? I guess I don't need to do this because I'm going to have my resin mixed. I'm just going to set this aside while we mix our resin.
Resin.
See. I'm out of art coat, I think. So I'll be using the countertop epoxy.
We're out of art coat?
I mean, I've got some in the shop, but I don't have any. Those are all countertop coats.
What is that?
I put an order in today.
There's no way.
That is awesome, Mary Jane. Megan, your everyday doodles have been so gorgeous. I mean, we've been using it. I'll just be working with a resin that does not have the working time that I'm used to. So y'all remind me of that. As I know, Gina, I had a doctor's appointment today, so that pushed me out of everything. I've got a new doctor in town because he was the only one basically accepting new patients during a pandemic. And he was 85, super sweet guy, reminded me a lot of my dad. But he gave me a big lecture about everything corona, which is awesome, because I think you need to educate people on pandemics, because if you're not told, then you won't know. But on top of filling out new patient paperwork and the lecture and my visit and my exam and all that, which should have been a, you know, let's say, for example, my next visit will probably be like 30 minutes. This one was like 4.5 hours. And then I had to go get a prescription filled, and they were out of the medication. So then I decided I'd be smart and call around and had to go to a pharmacy that was on the other side of town during 5 o'clock traffic. Anyways, I've been out all day today. But I'll be on the next Artapalooza. Fear not. I sent Clara a text letting her know I was at the doctor. Anyways. Hey, Lynn. That sucks, Sandra. Hopefully you'll find space soon. Still, Sherry, please send me a text so I can find out where the rest of your coasters are. I'm sorry, Evelyn. I will be there. I'll be at the next one. I promise. They took my temperature and all that, and I do not have the thing. We have to be careful about what we say on the channel because they're demonetizing videos and pulling videos because they don't want to create hysteria or spread bad info. So in order for you two to do that, they're just pulling everybody that talks about what's going on right now. So I didn't get tested, but I don't have any of the symptoms other than a sore throat. He said my throat was inflamed. And I explained to him I've been sneezing nonstop because of allergies. So, anyways, we're good. What's up, baby doll? Hey, El Spicy. I've been seeing you on Instagram. Thank you for all the comments. I'm glad you're here today. Vanessa. Copy. I'm so glad you say things like that. My family is military, so I understand. Copy. Hey, Johnny, how are you doing? Love the music you're putting out. As usual, if you guys don't know, Johnny Farrow is Mix Media Girl's husband. He is super, super talented musician. And he did a parody about the crud, and it's fantastic. You should check him out. Check out his YouTube. I know, it's awkward time to have allergies right now. I'm willing to bet that that is way not enough resin, but we'll deal with that as we go. So today we're gonna do an Easter color pour, which means I'm gonna be working with a whole bunch of colors that I usually don't work with. Johnny, if it lets you post the link, go for it. Otherwise, we'll get JJ to post it. I would add you as a moderator so you could post it, but my hands are sticky. Hey, TZ. Y'all, our little girl cat is the gassiest thing ever invented on Earth. Are y'all's girl cats gassy? Oof. Okay, so the colors we're going to use today are bright yellow. Y'all already know I have issues with making that work. We're going to use pink sherbet. We're going to use aqua. We're going to use titanium. And I feel like I should use a green rather than an orange, but I know that these two are going to make a green. But maybe I'll just leave it at this. What do y'all think about these colors? I know, Lynn, it's crazy. Gotcha. JJ, can you link or Lynn, Johnny Farrow's YouTube? Michelle, let's hope, because we're putting it in the piece today, and I'm pouring on a 16 by 20 canvas, not a cradle board, so it may be dipping in the middle, but that's okay. Y'all think I should add a deep color? I've got cherry handy. Or is that going to take it out of the realm of Easter? Oh, I know, Sandra, for sure. Alright, I went to get another color and I may have come back with two because those look really Eastery, no? become warm. More resin. But I'm not afraid to make some more resin. As long as y'all don't mind sitting here whilst I mix. Okay, so for those that don't know, you always want to put part B in first because it is thinner. And this will help you to mix your colors more completely. Because if you put part A in first, it's more likely to stick to the sides of the cup and harder to incorporate both parts together. I feel like that's more than e-science. I feel like I heard that from an actual other person. If you use stone coat, do I really have to put a UV coat on it? Thanks in advance. Megan, it should be fine with stone coat. So you guys, feel free to share this video with your family and friends and YouTube and, not YouTube, I don't think you can share on YouTube, but on Facebook, and if you're on Twitter, or if you're on Instagram. The best way to help out a channel is to share the love, and by love I mean the videos. It's all about outreach, and the more you share a channel, the more eyes we get in front of, and therefore the more subscribers, and therefore the better we grow as a channel. So, for any channel that you love out there, whether it's me or someone else, just share. Tara, thank you. Let me find the button. Really appreciate that, lady. Did how much for a simple flood coat? I'm not sure about the question. I'm barely on the cell phone, now I have to learn the zoomies. The zoomies as in when puppies run around, or the zoom, app for like video sharing. If you guys are doing the pour with me on the 25th, that will be on YouTube this time. It won't be on Zoom, so don't worry about learning a whole new platform for that. Megan, thank you for the $1.99. Appreciate it, y'all. Thank you, baby doll. Oh, Zoom. So, yeah. I think Jeff and I are going to do a video on Zoom. He's actually teaching me how to use it right now so that I can teach you guys. So, I think we're going to make sure you download it and have logged into it. And we'll do a video, maybe we'll do that tomorrow, of how to join a meeting, and we'll do a test run if you guys are up for that. I need my Stix. I got all this on me, but I did. I should change gloves. All right, I'm back. I'm not capable of learning one more thing. Well, if you're down to learn, I'm down to help. Or we may be doing classes via something. What's that other thing? Skype or FaceTime? But that'll be probably more one-on-one for whatever someone's most comfortable with working on. Okay, so this is bright yellow by Just Resin. It is a flat. There's no shimmer to it. It's super awesome color. And I feel like it's very Easter-y. Another awesome Easter yellow would be Lemonade from Color Passion. But I already have three Color Passion colors on this, and I don't want too many cell agents. I think this will actually even be too much. So we'll see. Hey, Kelly of Oz. What's up, Darcy in Vegas? Okay, so this next one is Pink Sherbet.
Pink Sherbet is one of my favorites. Like, that's a... That color goes with everything. If you guys haven't got Pink Sherbet, you've been sleeping.
Don't sleep on the sherb.
Don't sleep on the sherbet. It's truly amazing color.
Sounds like Jeff's in there doing dishes. You watched a Zoom tutorial on YouTube, Sandy. Did you learn anything you could share with the class? Because I'm still confused by it. So that's a metallic. Then I have to open a new white because I have used up one that I had over here. This is titanium from Yest Resin. Actually, I may use that with a white. So let's open up this Lavender Dream.
Don't trap them, Bo. Don't you trap them. You gotta trap.
So you guys just saw me open this all the way and see how low the quantity in this jar is. I had people contact me saying that I sold them a used jar. She just has this size jar, and I think she's working on getting a better sized jar because it does look like there's basically nothing in it. But it's by weight, not by volume, and so my recommendation was to get a better, more accurate volume jar, and I think they're working on that, but they have to go through all of these that they have purchased already. Okay. I wouldn't do that for sure, but some people just look for things to complain about. So, do you guys think that this is too much the same color? Should I use the aqua and the spearmint, or just one or the other?
That's good. That all goes. That one's a little aggressive for Easter.
Yeah.
Ow.
Ow.
Okay, she wasn't ready for her close-up, Mr. DeVille. Alright, so this is Spearmint by Color Passion. It's very Breakfast at Tiffany's, but a little bit warmer. A little bit yellowy, huey.
I thought you said you didn't want a lot in there when you did this.
I have to cut them. It doesn't matter how much this. I want an opaque color still. I just have to mix it. Like, I used to do Stone Coat with titanium. I would need to do that with Breakfast. But I didn't bring those colors over here, so I'm just rolling with it.
Ah.
How it is. But yeah, one more question.
Nope. That'll be $6.
All right, put it on the tab.
What is it?
Do you think I should put a dark color in this? Because there's no, like, depth, or...
Maybe a purple?
I did a purple.
No. Gold or silver? Use a gold to cut it, to make it like the little veins and
what color am I missing, y'all?
Those are all good Easter colors.
Megan, thank you for the 20 twin twin.
20 man.
There's some gold.
Thanks.
Or that or something else.
Now, Claire's been banging out those masks. She's doing the Lord's work lately. People need those. I'm glad she's doing it because I don't know how.
What do you think, Chloe? They're crazy, aren't they? Are they crazy? Uh-oh.
Okay. So, Judy!
Get him, Bowie.
How are you, gorgeous? So this was a piece that I had before, and I sprayed it with one coat of spray gesso. I can still see through it a little bit. So I'm probably going to... make the majority of my grease paint white. So that kind of covers up a little bit. If I could find my white. Found it. Glad you made a live too, Judy. Cherry, deep purple. So Judy, I'm trying to figure out for my Easter colors what I'm missing, what I need, or if I should just roll like it is.
Maybe some white, maybe an opposite of a little dark. Like,
I just made
my negative space.
Actually a lot lighter. It looks closer to it on this camera. Peach and gold. B, do we have a peach over there?
How about that peach? I have no idea.
I don't think I have peach.
I don't think I've ever heard of peach.
Hey, Liz. There's just something about putting my hand into resin that I love so much. Can't be the only ones. I can't be the only ones. Like, I'm two people. Most of them.
He's got zoomies.
Turn the camera. Hopefully I can catch some of them. Dark, you can barely see it, but so I'm not gonna add a lime just because I already have one scary color, and the spearmint
get you
next to the yellow will make a lime color. like I have an apricot.
You have four colors there now.
I know. So I'm using this torch to pop the bubbles and to make everything a little bit more fluid. Also, having these bubbles popped will show me if there's anything in my resin that shouldn't be there after you run a torch over your surface. If there's any texture, then you know that's something that shouldn't be there. You can go ahead and remove it so you don't have to worry about it ruining your design after you pour your resin. That's a little black kitty here. Where is this one? What did we get for putting this on the floor while it was drying? Next to where the kitties like to party.
Alright.
Winded? Okay. So. Dirty pour. Pepsi pour and swipe. How should we do this, y'all? Just hyper focused in on this surface being pretty. Okay. I don't know how I want to do this. I'm going to go ahead and just pour this out into a couple mini cups because this is not art coat. This is a countertop epoxy and I don't want it to set up on me too fast. Can you do a ring pour? So, I could do that, Liz. The reason why I'm not going to do a ring pour is because I've got three colors. No. Yes. No. Two colors. That will create too many cells and it'll be too busy if I try to do a ring pour with the brands of colors I chose, unfortunately. Ew, this turned out to be a pretty color. Puddle pour, draw a line through, and tilt. We could do puddle pour. Maybe we'll get a little Dutch with it. Since we've got silly things floating around. What's what?
Show Lego.
Where they do Lego-y things.
I know that.
Okay. Lavender. Spearmint. titanium. Put a fun little bullseye. A pendulum pour. I did pendulum pour like 3 years ago, and it was probably one of the most stressful things I'd ever tried to figure out. You'll have to go back and look through my videos for that. Okay. This is resin.
Hey, did you just send this to his thing? Like his messages, or did you post on his page?
I put it everywhere. So I'm letting this fill back into the center. Tilt it. See how there's like green showing up and a whole bunch of colors that we didn't use are presenting. So Megan, you'll need 3 ounces per square foot for an 1/8 inch pour. All right, so now I'm gonna use the heat to heat the outside to get certain areas to stretch. Well, it looks like this side is gonna be more fluid for the time being, so. interesting, you guys. Don't know if it's my favorite so far, but I'm going to try to manipulate it into something I can love. I'm hitting the heat in certain areas to get the resin to break and the cells to pop up.
Okay, cool.
Which is what's happening right here. So then when I stretch it back in the other direction, those cells will grow. When we pull it back this way. Let it set for a minute and cool off. Hey Clara, how was the thing today? Now I'm heating just in front of the area that I want to start moving. Adding too much heat to the actual art area because I don't want to put too much heat on those selling agents. Tilting slightly off and bringing it back in. I like the edges and the outside of this, but the middle part, not my favorite. Make it do what we want it to do. I'm just still trying to figure out what it is I want it to do. Using heat to just touch it in areas where I want cells to pop up, because that'll thin it out. This is something else, you guys. Probably right here. turkey dripped in Easter paint. I guess since Easter was part of that description, I'm down with it. Definitely not my most shining piece ever.
What happened?
It just didn't do.
Now I'm excited.
No. Whoa. It's got a lot of cool parts in it.
Yeah.
So I'm going to take this to the dust free zone and I will decide its fate tomorrow. And I'll get something else to pour on. Right. Karen, I hope not also. Please keep me posted if you do. Alright. To make some more white. Clara, agreed. All right. Let's do a tree ring. But I'm going to grease the pan with this peach we made with mango and titanium. Solid background. It doesn't have to be a thick layer of grease. Which is good because there's not a lot here. Should have done this on a 10-incher, but that's fine. It will be fine. So what did you guys do today? How was your quarantining? Now, I bet if I threw some glitter glass at that last one we did, it would look like a stunner. Experiment. separate this yellow with a bit of white. Our peach stick to give it a little swirl. Here we go. My swirls look like the top of Little Debbie. Cakes, there we go. Gonna turn this upside down on the co-star. Let that drain out. Hit the outside with some heat so that our ring flows as easily as it can, since it's a thin grease. This is where we're at right now. I just start this by saying my tree rings have never come out really that great. But we're looking for a winner. Hey, Penny. Oh, it's been in two pieces because that's the only way to turn it off.
Well, the battery's out of it. This thing?
Yeah. I promise I picked pretty colors. They just decided to mix with each other and go. Let's put some heat on this sucker and see what happens. Maybe some magic will appear. We're getting some cells in the white. There used to be pink in here. I did not use a green. Hey, Chris. Hey, Laura Taylor. See if we can stretch some of these cells out while keeping the rings intact. So this one turned out better than our Easter one. Yeah, Tara, the boys are playing with the squeaky toys. Hello, Sue. Laura Taylor, what is up? It needs some bling. Okay, so I can add some bling. Thing is, it's gonna disrupt the rings. Clara, thank you. Oh, you got the name I did for you today? The one and only. It's a one-off. Y'all have been really good about, like, getting things on my elbow. Bow, 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 bow. I do elevator buttons. Pow, pow buttons. Doors. If Jeff's talking back. All those things get elbowed. High fives. Add a touch of pink glitter. Listen, you've been kind of a crappy bartender because you got yourself a drink and not me.
Because I thought you already had
them. You always have drink. What are you talking about?
Elbow power.
I could definitely say the same because you always start with wine and I never see a drink.
But you're usually working and you don't like to drink when you're working. Do you think I should add glitter to this? Hey, I got a successful tree ring for and it looks like this.
It's fun.
Clara said she would also like a drink, but also with an umbrella too, please.
No umbrellas here.
Are we gonna fire or no fire? DL, we carry around wipes, no joke. That's for real in this day and age. And time and age.
Come on, let's go out.
All right.
Bowie?
You can't hate on tree rings anymore, I got one.
Come on.
I got one to do what it's supposed to do.
Let's go. Come on, mister.
Hey, nope. Out.
Come on, you guys.
I don't know how I'm gonna add glitter to this and not interrupt it. So I'll do one on a coaster. I don't know how to add glitter to this and not interrupt the rings.
Come on, guys.
Okay, let me put this one up. I'm sorry to disappoint you guys, but I'll do a coaster with glitter. That's the first tree ring you've ever liked? That's so sweet. So, tree rings are really hard to do in resin. I'm not really sure why. Obviously, it's the consistency. They are not playing.
Oh. Did you hear that?
Mm-hmm. Always being a big brother to the kitties. He pinned one. Okay. So, let's do the purple first. No. Yes, let's do the white first. I think I'm gonna throw some like glass shards at the first one we did tonight, so y'all don't go anywhere. Yeah. picture rings look like they'd be like fairly simple.
Chloe.
Because you're just swirling resin around, you know? But I gotta tell you, they can be an all the way uphill battle. I'm not sure if I like the order I put these colors down, but we will see together, shall we? Shall. Not bad so far. I messed up the center.
Chloe.
I'm not sure if it's better policy to roll it all the way around or bring it back to the center. Karen said thank you for her name. Okay. Just gonna use all of this runoff for my grease, as it were.
Bowie.
Boys being hyper today. So I'm just swirling it around and letting it stretch to the edge. But I know a lot of people just tilt to the edge and bring it back. And then go to the next edge, bring it back. There's no wrong way to do this. I am not convinced with these colors, I'll tell you that. Let's put some more aqua in there. I'll try again. Yeah, thank you. Get my elbow over here.
Move that over there.
Because that would be too intelligent for me. I didn't think about it. Alright, I think these colors are going to look way better. Anybody else abort mid tree ring sometimes? Change up the script a little bit. I have to let some of this run off because it's gonna do it anyways because there's too much resin on the surface. Resin's only going to hold up to an eighth inch.
Hey, Joe, what are you doing? Uh-oh, there he is. Get him. Get him. Get
I'm just adding into the dirty cup as I go. Whatever color is lacking, I'm just adding that on. I'm just gonna dip this to grease it. Waste not, want not. Have you guys tried doing a tree ring? Do you like it better with acrylics or resin? Or has it just not been your thing? Just breathe, Miz. So Terry, you did it with acrylics then? Yeah, with acrylics, you have to pay attention to how different color and weight react. I hope that made sense, because it came out funny. With acrylics, you have to pay attention to what colors you're using, because different colors have different weights, and different weights do different things. I tend to stick with resin, because it's more about what chemicals you got going on rather than the weight. Add more white, but that'll be fine. So these are turning out to be pretty interesting. I think I have enough left for one more ring. And then I'm going to add some glass to that first piece that we did. Because I don't think it is going to do anything on its own that's going to make me like the piece. And when you consider making adjustments to a painting that you've just done, you should either let it just do do what it's going to do overnight and see how you feel about it the next morning. Because a lot of times, the next day, you'll have different feelings about a piece. A lot of times, I kind of... That works for me. But also, I feel like I've been doing this for so long that I can look at a piece and tell that there's nothing it could do on its own that would make me like, I'm glad I let that just do what it's gonna do. And I'm pretty sure that that piece is one of those. So you have to really consider if I add whatever it is that you're gonna do or whatever method you're gonna mess with the piece, if I do this and it goes wrong, will I like it any less? Like, is there a level of mess up that you could do to it that it isn't already? If that makes sense? The pieces that I don't favor and consider doing other stuff to are usually the pieces that I decide to do experiments or a technique that I've been considering but didn't want to waste the resin on. So that's what that piece is going to end up being for us today. It's going to be a sacrifice and a study of something new. Hello, Yaritza. Oh, yeah. Gloves definitely need to be changed, but also YOLO. I think this is going to be more than one. So I need to have this ready. Nene, thank you. It makes me feel like I'm icing a cake as well. Alrighty. Trying to do this on camera without dripping on anything below. I'll let that sit and see what it does. Work on this one. I think I'm going to attempt another Easter pour tomorrow and use some metallics instead. because I think the metallics are less likely to mix with each other and create, while this is pretty mud, it's still mud, in my opinion. All right, let's hit these with some heat. I'm gonna take them to the dust-free zone. And then we're gonna add some texture to that first one that we did together. Cool? Cool. Look out, Tiny Moon. Wipe down the drain torch. Forgot that we had this one. Don't know if anything will come of it since it's not a lot of resin on there. Alright, here is our first piece of the night. It has a lot going on, therefore, let's make some adjustments. And then after this, I promise I'll clean off the torch and everything else. So yeah, a lot going on here. throw some glitter glass at it and see if we can change our opinion of it. Not glitter glass, just regular glass. Parker. I'm just letting the resin act as the adhesive for the glass. Basically, I'm just going to make it extra. Because why not? Why not get down a little boy cat? Donna, they're basically gone. Thank you for asking. Shall we add some glitter glass? I think so. Here we go. Halo. Alright. I'm going to add this glitter glass down the center where I have the larger chunks of fire glass. This is going to give extra sparkle. I think I'm going to trail some out on these little tendrils. Can I call them tendrils as well? Okay. Now, basically, trying to update any Bowie. Be sweet.
Building a mansion and building other store.
pinching and twisting my fingers really tightly, I can lay on really thin areas of glitter. I'm trying to go with the flow of the piece. I don't want to go in any lines or directions that is against the grain, I guess you could say. Right then. I don't know if I enhanced it, but I know it's not worse. Can I, what do you need a phone? I need to inspect my glitter level. Thanks. One thing's for sure, there's no painting over this one. Right, Gina? You be safe, TZ. There's definitely parts I like about the piece.
So sad.
Maybe once it relaxes and just does what it's gonna do. We'll like it even more. I'm just gonna let this guy be.
What, babe?
I threw everything but the kitchen sink at it. Never any sound on that camera. My bad, you guys. So, B, do you want to see my, I put everything on it piece? Just don't throw up. But what is it?
Why?
Because it just wasn't, and so I made it everything.
Oh, very nice. Okay, mister.
Something else.
I love these cats.
Do we have any announcements for people?
No. Do you guys want some food? Are you hungry? You look like you want some food. Please don't crawl up this. Please don't do that. Your water's all dirty.
I'll fix them up. Word them up. So, y'all, I hope at the very least you learned something that you can incorporate on your channel. And at the very most, I hope you had a good time. I always have a good time hanging out with you guys. I basically don't even care if it works out or not, as long as I get to hang out with y'all. I actually only have like 4 of the, well, 5. I have 5 of the Pour With Us kits left. I just ordered some more mini kits so that I can make more of them. Hopefully they get here in time, but if they don't, then I only have 4 more.
Cujo, leave them alone.
But this time it will be on YouTube, and if we can figure out a way to make it work on Zoom and it's not too confusing for people, then it'll be on, we're going to test it out with Zoom. Are there any people in here that would be interested in doing a test with me to see if the Zoom thing is working and how I can utilize that for the channel? Are there any guinea pigs that can test it with us that want to try it tomorrow? If so, shoot me a text at 214-402-9996. Zoom's all glitchy right now. I'm sure there's like a billion zillion people on it. I think the idea of doing Zoom is an interesting one because then I can hear your questions. That being said, depending on how many people you have in it, there could be too many people talking at the same time. Thank you, Clara. Clara, for sure, I'm going to need you to download it so that you can assist me in just seeing how it works and how I can teach people how to do it if you've got time. So, yeah. If you kind of want another... You never know what someone's going through. And in this, with everything that's going on right now, you have a little bit more of an idea of what's going through. It's crazy out there, people. It's crazy. Anyways, thank you so much for tuning in and seeing what we're up to today. We love you guys so much. Do us a favor, subscribe, give us your thumbs, whether they're up or down, I really don't care. And don't forget to hit the bell for sometimes notifications, sometimes YouTube doesn't wanna. And, share the videos. It's all we can ask of you guys. If you're interested in any of the colors we used tonight or the resin art coat, you can get it on our website, artisttilldeath.com. That's 2 T's, 2 L's. You can find all of our information over here. And what time are we going live tomorrow?
No idea.
I don't even know what tomorrow is. But we'll be live tomorrow. Hope to see you guys there. Till then, Jen! Thanks for coming in. Shoot me a text, and we'll see you guys mañana. Bye.
I said bye.
Wait, do you have anything that needs a clear coat?